Hi, welcome again. Today we are going to see software testing part 3, that is test design strategies in black box testing. As we have seen in the previous session, we have three different techniques. One is equivalence partitioning, boundary value analysis, and cause and effect graph testing. Since black box testing is a data-driven testing, it mainly focuses on the input and the output condition. But in real world scenario, due to time and budget issues, it is not possible to do exhaustive testing for all the test inputs. Especially when there is a large pool of test cases, you need to reduce the number of test cases to reduce the time. In order to achieve that, we are going for these three techniques. Well, in equivalence partitioning, that input data which we are going to give for testing is divided into different equivalence data classes. For example, if you have an input box that accepts numbers between 1 to 100, it is not necessary to test all the 100 inputs for the testing because it takes lot of time to test all the 100 inputs. In order to avoid that, we are splitting the test input into three different classes. First one is a valid scenario, second one is invalid, that is below the lower limit, and third one is invalid, which is above the upper limit. So in this case, 1 to 100, what are the valid scenarios? 100 and the numbers between 1 to 100. That could be anything, 30, 40, 50. So we will pick any data, any valid data to test that product. The second thing is value below lower limit. Here the lower limit is 1. So we will test the values, that is, it could be either 0 or minus 1, minus 10, minus 20, any value which is below 1. And the third one is greater than 100, that is any value above 100. It could be 101, 105, 300, 500, 1000, any value. So from these three different classes, you will select any three values as the input data for the testing. This is called equivalence partitioning. So finally, what we have achieved is, instead of testing all the 100 inputs, we have taken only 3 values. For example, 1, minus 1 and 200. So obviously the test cases will get reduced and the time will be eventually reduced. The next is boundary value analysis. In this technique, we are going to identify the defects exactly at the boundaries of the input data rather at the center. As we seen in the previous example in equivalence partition, if you want to test between 1 and 100, you will take between 100 and also 1 to 100 and also the limits below and the limits above the upper limit. But here in this case, we are exactly testing at the boundaries. For example, the same scenario between 1 and 100. First, we will take the values, that is exactly the boundary, that is 1 and 100 in our case. The second is extreme edges of input, which is below the input. That is, for example, in 1, what is below 1, 0, that is extreme edge, and then in 100, below 100 is 99. So we will take these two values for testing. The third is above the extreme edges, 1 and above 1 is 2 and 101 is the one value which is above the extreme edge. So in this case, instead of testing all the 100 inputs, we have taken only 6 values of input for testing the application. This is called boundary value analysis. And the last one is cause and effect graph technique. Here we have to draw a cause and effect graph based on the requirements, and we will look for the mutually exclusive causes. After screening out the causes, we will check for the redundancy and reduce the number of redundant test cases and finalize the test case scenarios. For example, if you are testing a movie ticket booking application, you just imagine there are two fields. One is name, the other one is phone number. So in the name field, the application will expect you to enter the characters, and in the phone number, the application will expect you to enter the digits. So in any of these fields, if you are giving the invalid input, the effect, that is the error message which application is going to pop up, will be different. So the cause of the input and the effect, that will depend upon the cause and effect of the application will depend upon the input condition, and according to that you are going to derive the test cases. This is called cause and effect graph technique. So the last one is interview questions related to this topic. Mostly they will ask the comparison between equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis, and also they will give the input conditions, and they will ask you how you will derive the input data. As we seen in the example, they might ask you if the input field accept numbers between 10 and 100 or 1000 and 2000, then what will be your input data for equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis. The next question is, they might ask you the cause and effect graph technique downsides. So since it has advantages, like it reduces the total number of test cases, it also has the disadvantages, like it will consume a lot of time because it models all our requirements into the cause and effect graph before writing test cases. So it consumes a lot of time. So that's all for today's session. Hope you like it. And if you want to learn more about software testing, please subscribe to our channel, We People. Thank you.